हेलो सीएस स्कॉलर्स, दिस इज पार्ट टू ऑफ यूनिट फाइव, द टाइगर, द होली मैन एंड द जैपल फ्रॉम इंग्लिश वर्क बुक। टुडे वी विल बी डूइंग वर्कशीट नंबर टू, थ्री, फोर एंड फाइव। लेट्स स्टार्ट। टेक आउट पेज नंबर 40, वर्कशीट नंबर टू। चिल्ड्रन, आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन्ड यू What homonyms are? Homonyms are words that have same spelling and same pronunciation, but they have different meanings. Now, what you have to do in exercise A, that in this exercise, the words are given twice. Now, you have to use a dictionary to find the two different meanings of these words and write down the meanings in the space provided. Now, the words are given twice. You have to find two different meanings of these words. Let's see number two. The word is ring. The first meaning of ring is a circular piece of jewelry that you wear on your finger. Yes. And another meaning of ring is the sound a bell makes. So, like this, you have to find the meanings of these words and you have to write it here. Take out page number 41, exercise B. Use any of these two words in sentences to bring out both meanings. Now, children, in exercise B, you have to make sentences using the words which are given in exercise A. Now, in exercise A, you have to find two different meanings of that words, and in exercise B, you have to make two different sentences in which two different meanings should be there. For example, in exercise A, we got the meanings of the word ring. Now, let's frame this word in a sentence. First one, please do not ring the doorbell or the baby will wake up. Another one, I bought a gold ring for my mother. So, I framed here two different sentences in which different meanings are coming out of that word. Understood? So, like this, you have to use that words which are given in exercise A, and in exercise B, you have to frame the sentences of that words. Clear? Now come to exercise C. Choose the correct word to end each sentence. One has been done for you. Number one, north east to south, as polite east to rude. Rude or friendly, children? The options are given. You have to choose the correct word. Means you have to find the opposite words of these words, like north, south, polite, rude. Next one, cry is to laugh, as sad is to happy. I know you will easily find these sentences. Take out page number 42, worksheet number 3, exercise A. Choose the correct word to complete each sentence. Now here, in this exercise, children, you have to use personal pronouns and possessive pronouns. I have already told you that personal pronouns are classified as subject pronouns and object pronouns. I, he, she, it, you, we, they are subject pronouns. And the words like her, him, me, us, them are object pronouns. Object pronouns are the part of predicate, and object pronouns are used after the verbs, and subject pronouns are used before the verbs. And what are possessive pronouns? Possessive pronouns are those pronouns which show ownership, that something belongs to someone. Now let's see number one. That is my camera. It belongs to dash. Me or mine? Me is the correct word, because whenever in the sentence belongs or belong is used, you will use me. If I say that is my camera, it is mine. If I use it is, then at that time you will use mine. Understood? So whenever the word belongs is there, you will use me, because you are talking about your own camera. Number two, Sarah is my sister. Dash goes to college. Now children, here the verb is goes, and before the verb blank is given. So before the verb, which pronoun should we use children? Subject pronoun or the object pronoun? Subject pronoun. So which is the correct word? She or her? She goes to college. So like this, try to get the answers of these sentences. Now come to exercise B. Choose the correct reflexive pronouns from the box to complete these sentences. Now, what are reflexive pronouns, children? Reflexive pronouns are those pronouns when we want to point back to the doer of the action in a sentence. Means when we want to refer back to the subject. Now, the words like myself, yourself, ourselves, itself, himself, themselves are reflexive pronouns. Now you have to choose the correct reflexive pronoun from the box. See number one. This is your work. Do it dash. So do it. Who is the doer of the action, children? Who will do the action? You. Your. So your reflexive pronoun would be yourself. So try to find out the doer of the action, the subject in the sentence, and try to get the answers of these sentences. Page number 43, worksheet number 4, exercise A. Say these words out loud. Make sure the S and the Z sounds are pronounced correctly. Children, in the box, a few words are given and you have to say these words out loud and you have to recognize the sound of S and Z. See the word shoes, Z. At the end, Z sound is there. Shoes, Z sound. Next, mess. In this word, the sound is S. Mess, sir. So like this, say these words out loud and recognize the sounds. In exercise B, place these words in the correct column according to the sound of S and Z. Children, in the box, a few words are given and say these words, recognize the sound of these words, and you have to write in the given table. The first one, gloves, Z sound is there. So you have to write under the Z column. Next, hats, S sound is there. So you will write this word hats under the S column. So like this, you have to do the exercise. Take out page number 44, worksheet number 5. Write the paragraph expressing what would have happened if the sage had not transformed the mouse back to his original form. Refer to the story in worksheet number 1. This will be your story ending. Now children, in this worksheet, you have to write a paragraph and you have to express your thoughts, you have to give your ideas that What would have happened if the sage had not changed the mouse into his original form? Children, if the sage had not changed the mouse into his original form, then what would have happened in the forest? Now, this will be your conclusion, your ending part. So, write a paragraph, give your ideas, create your own thoughts. I will be sending you the notes. Bye bye. Good day.